Hey guys, it's Hannah. Welcome back to my channel. So this is a new angle because I like rearranged my entire room since last time I filmed, and I have nowhere else to film. So I'm gonna try a different angle next time because I am filming two videos in one day. So if you guys see me with this hoodie on and my hair like this again, it's because I'm filming another video right after this. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Please like, comment, subscribe, and let's just get started. I'm so excited for this video. Oh my gosh. Oh, I didn't tell you what the video was. Okay, wait. Back up. Today I'm going to be doing a Christian Q&A or like a faith Q&A. Again, like I said in my 2020 like plan thing, I wanted to do more faith and Christian related videos since that is something very important to me because I am a Christian. So I'm so excited. It's like my first Christian video on this channel, and I cannot be any more excited. So anyway, I am filming on my old phone, so if the quality is kind of like weird, that's why. Anyway, let's just get started. The first question is, when did you become a Christian? So I've always been a Christian. We always go to church on Sundays, and that's like when I was growing up, we always go to church. We always used to go to church on Sundays also. We still do go to church. And sometimes me and my sister and my friend, we would always perform in front of the entire church, and we would dance and stuff, and it was just so much fun. And then I also got baptized a few years ago. So yes, I've always been a Christian. I feel like a lot of people say that they don't have time for God. They don't have time to read His word. They don't have time to learn more about Jesus. So I feel like for how much we are on our phones, for how much we are on TikTok, for how much we are on Instagram, for how much we are on Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, literally everything, that time can be used for God, but we decide to use it for TikTok, if that makes sense. So instead of reading the word, we would rather, you know what I mean? So like how many hours people are watching YouTube, watching Netflix, that time can be used for Jesus, but you choose not to. I feel like that is an excuse that a lot of people use, is that they don't have time, but we're constantly on our phones. Also, there's literally YouTube videos. You can Bible study on YouTube, which I sometimes do. I usually watch Melanie Cicotti and Celeste Rain Man. So I watch them too, and I watch their Bible studies. Literally, Celeste, she literally uploads a Faith Friday every Friday, and she has a lot of Bible studies. She's constantly having Bible studies up. You guys can even download the Bible app on your phone for free. You can get a Bible from the dollar store for $1. You can listen to podcasts. What I would usually do is, let me just show you guys what I would usually do. I use a YouVersion Bible on my phone, and literally, it's free on the App Store. And I use that, and I will listen. Like, I sometimes watch Celeste's Bible studies or Melena's, or Melena, I think it's Melena. And then sometimes I would also go to something called the Bible Recap. It's a podcast. This is just a Google podcast app, but literally a lot of podcasts or like all podcast apps are free, honestly. And you scroll down, you literally see all of these like Bible studies, and so you see like Genesis 1 through 3, Genesis 1 through 4. So usually, say I was doing Genesis 1 through 3, I would read Genesis 1 through 3 on the Bible app, and then I would go into the Bible Recap podcast, and I would just listen to them, and it basically just explains, it just explains like what you just read to help you understand more. So I really do recommend it, and I really do love it. And also like watch church on YouTube. I give you a few ideas. There's things on YouTube. We're on YouTube all the time. Like there's YouTubers that Bible study online, like we're constantly on our phones. There's apps for it. Like there's no excuses that you don't have time for God, because you do. You just choose not to use it on Him. Question number two is, what is a passage slash verse that has helped you? There are so many. So first it says, with God all things are possible, which is Matthew 19:26. I also have one saved as my lock screen or screensaver, and it says, turn your, sorry, I have Face ID so it's not really like working here. Okay, so it says, turn your worries into prayers. And then I also have a little thing back here, and this says, let your faith be bigger than your fears. I love this. This has helped me so much. This one says, she is more precious than jewels. Proverbs 3:31-10. There are just so many. There was a lot that helped me through a lot, and this video would just be way too long, and this video would never end. The next question is, any advice for anyone who wants to give their life to Christ? There are so many things I can tell you. First, just simple, just do it. Honestly, just do it. You'll see so many blessings, so many changes, and good changes in your life. Just remember that God is waiting for you with open arms. Whenever you do decide to give your life to Christ, He is always welcoming you and waiting you with open arms. So I'm gonna actually help you with that right now. I'm writing this off paper because I did this before to a lot of people at like stores and things like that.
So just a disclaimer, this next part is for anybody that would like to give their life to Jesus Christ right now. I am not whatsoever in any way, shape, or form forcing you to do this. If you are not ready, that is perfectly fine. When you are ready, just remember that He is waiting for you with open arms always. Again, if you are not ready, just skip over this part of the video. It's perfectly fine. Do it when you are ready. But if you are ready to give your life to Jesus Christ in a few seconds, I'm going to tell you to repeat some stuff after me.
If you would like to receive this free gift of Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, just say this with me. Jesus, come into my heart, forgive me of my sins, wash me, change me, and set me free. Let me never be the same again. Jesus, I believe you died for me. Help me to live for you and fulfill everything you have called me to do. I thank you that I am now forgiven and on my way to heaven. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so I'm really quickly just gonna read this part also. So, I have the best news anyone can ever tell you. As a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I tell you today that all your sins are forgiven you right now, and you can know for sure that you're on your way to heaven. Remember, when you make a mistake, don't run from God, run to Him, because He loves you and He does have an awesome plan for your life. Oh my gosh, I'm so happy right now. Okay, next is, what is your favorite Christian song? There are so many of my favorite Christian songs. Okay, so first, well, these are not in any order. I just like all of them. So first one is Reckless Love by Corey Asbury. I have no idea, but I'll link this all down below for you guys. So You Say by Lauren Daigle, I think that's how you say it. Another one is Oh Come to the Altar by Evelation Worship. What a Beautiful Name by Hillsong Worship. The Newsboys' God's Not Dead. Holy Spirit by Francesca Bastalelli. And also The Breakup Song by Francesca Bastalelli. I don't know how to say that. And that has helped me through so much. Michael W. Smith, Surrounded, Fight My Battles. Corin Hawthorne, Won't He Do It? Who You Say I Am, Hillsong Worship. Avenue North, Control. No Wonder, Conquered. Stephen Curtis Champman, Do Everything. Another one by Francesca Bastalelli, I had no idea. Defender. Oceans Where My Feet May Fail by Hillsong United. Overcomer by Mandisa. Those are just some, but again, there are just so many more that I really do love. Favorite Christian YouTubers, and this is the last question. So I have tons of favorite Christian YouTubers. I of course mentioned two, which is Melania Cicati and Celeste Rain Man. I also really like Allie Brooke. Her video, guys, oh my gosh, the exact name of the video, and I'll link it down below because it is honestly the sweetest thing ever, and it's just so powerful, and I just love it so much. Like, I almost cried on it, and it is To My Daughter From Your Single Mom and Our Father in Heaven, and it's like, that's like the thumbnail right there. But guys, it is honestly, just please go watch it. It is so powerful and so amazing and beautiful. Just make sure you guys go watch that, because honestly, it's so good. Neen Impala or something like that. I'll link all these channels down below also, so you guys can go check them out. I'm actually done filming this video, but I just want to add this in quick. Actually, Bible study with my family every single night. So my family, we all come together into one room, and sometimes my boyfriend, sometimes my cousin. Either way, we all come into one room, and we will first read Jesus Calling Book. So it's just like daily devotions. So we will read this, and then at the bottom of it, so let's, for example, this is already one that we read, but there are like little like scriptures at the bottom here, and we will go into our Bible. We usually use the Good News Bible, and we will read that scripture, and we all just pray and just read the Bible, and it's honestly so amazing. And that's like my favorite part of the day, is just coming together as a family into one room and just reading the Bible, and it's just honestly amazing. And it's right before, we always do it right before bed. I do with my family that I just wanted to like talk about in this video, but anyway, let's get on with the video. Okay guys, that was it for this video. That was all the questions. If you guys would like to see anything else like this, comment down below some Christian video ideas that you guys would like to see. I hope this helped any of you out there. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys. Hey guys, goodbye. Oh, get out of there. I don't like that. Hold on, get out. Put you here instead. Is that better? Hey guys, it's Hannah. Welcome back to my channel. So this is absolutely terrible and this angle is absolutely terrible too. I can't find out where to film. Where do I film? Because this is not a good angle. I don't like it. Okay, let's find somewhere else to film. First question is, when did you become a Christian? First question is, when did you become a Christian? So I'm hot. Okay, so when did you become a Christian? So our first question is, when did you become a Christian? We use it. I don't know how to say this. I need to pray.